Thanks, Lewis. The headlines in the southeast today. A mother who lost her baby after being refused hospital treatment sets up a bereavement charity in his name.
No parent should ever have to feel what it is to not have your child coming home.
Residents near an illegal dump threaten legal action against the Environment Agency.
And we're on the Sunshine Express to an increasingly warm weekend. How hot will it get? I'll give you the full forecast later on in the programme.
Hello, welcome to the programme. I'm Ellie Crissell. A mother whose unborn son died because she was told by a midwife to stay at home when she called the hospital pleading for help late in her pregnancy has set up a new charity in her son's name. Theo's Foundation will campaign for safer maternity care and support for bereaved families, says his mum, Christina Pepper, so nobody else has to experience the pain and loss she's been through. The hospital trust says it's carried out an extensive investigation to make improvements. Leanne Rinney's report contains some images you may find distressing.
It's been nearly a year since Christina and Lee Pepper had to say goodbye to their baby son, Theo. Christina was 8 months pregnant and high risk when she started to lose a lot of fluid. She called her hospital's helpline to raise concerns, but was told by a midwife to stay at home.
To not feel listened to in the first instance was awful, you know, and I came away from that call feeling very stupid and, oh, I've bothered them and, you know, they're so busy. And then when we had the awful news that he'd gone, to have it all, it was like it clicked into place, everything that had happened, and you are just hit with this raw pain and you can't describe that pain, you can't.
The couple have now set up a new charity to campaign for safer maternity care and provide educational resources and support for other bereaved families.
For us, it's so important that we can do something for those families, no matter how small, even if it is just meeting for a coffee and sitting in silence, or whether it's holding their hand through their own court cases for justice, you know, whatever it is that that family needs, it should be given, because no parent should ever have to feel what it is to not have your child coming home.
The Medway NHS Foundation Trust say they've carried out an investigation to identify and implement improvements to the service. But Christina and Lee say they are still waiting for an apology from the hospital and reassurance that this won't happen again. Leanne Rinney, BBC Southeast Today, Sheerness.
And if you've been affected by anything in that report, there is help and support available via the BBC Action Line website, bbc.co.uk/actionline. Campaigners fighting for the cleanup of thousands of tonnes of illegally dumped waste in a Kent woodland are threatening legal action against the Environment Agency. Solicitors Lee Day have now sent a letter to the agency on behalf of those local residents, saying a contractor needs to be urgently instructed to carry out the clearance of Hodes Wood near Ashford.
The Environment Agency have spent the past 3 months going through a procurement process, which we don't believe needs to be carried out given the urgency of the situation. Now, it's great that the Environment Agency is going through the proper processes, but we believe it would be lawful to go through an urgent procurement procedure, and that would allow the Environment Agency to instruct a contractor to deal with the waste immediately.
Well, our environment correspondent Yvette Austin joins you now. Hello, Yvette. This has been rumbling on for quite some time now for residents, hasn't it?
It has, and they are really angry with the Environment Agency. First of all, they say they let the waste be dumped there in the first place from August last year, and it wasn't shut down until January. And campaigners then got the Environment Secretary involved to effectively order the Environment Agency to pay for it and to clear it, but still nothing's happening. And all the time, the ecosystem is suffering. There are trees dying. There could be waste chemicals, if you like, going into the ground below. And they say they've just had enough.
And what does the Environment Agency say then?
Well, it says that it is working with DEFRA to appoint a contractor as quickly as possible. It's continuing to monitor the site, and it says with no negative effect being seen. Let's face it, though, we are talking government departments. They take a long time for anything, really, let's face it. But the residents aren't happy with that at all.
Yvette, thank you. Sussex Police are recruiting extra staff to investigate potential manslaughter charges at an NHS trust. The force is advertising for criminal investigators to join Operation Bramber, which is looking into more than 100 cases of alleged medical negligence at two surgery departments at University Hospitals Sussex. The trust says it's cooperating fully with the inquiry and will continue to do whatever is needed to support that process. A new report into social housing in Brighton and Hove has identified serious failings. Significant improvement is needed to ensure properties meet electrical safety rules and to deal with a backlog of thousands of repairs, according to the regulator of social housing. Brighton and Hove City Council says it's taking urgent measures, including investing more than £15 million to improve its housing supply. On to football, both Gillingham and Crawley Town start their new seasons tomorrow. The Gills, under new manager Mark Bonner, will host Carlisle United. After their promotion last year, Crawley Town will kick off their campaign in League One, hosting Blackpool. Kickoff is at 5:30. And what is the weather going to be like for that? Well, I've got a smile on my face, haven't I, John?
You certainly have, yeah. Ellie likes the heat. Of course, as soon as the football season starts, the temperatures soar, and they are set to soar, certainly through Sunday and Monday. Before that, not too hot, just pleasantly warm through the rest of today and into Saturday. But yes, by Sunday and Monday, sweltering. Now, we've got fresh southwesterly winds at the moment, as I say, not too hot, low humidity. So all in all, quite pleasant out there. Some fair weather cloud, but it ain't going to rain through the rest of the day, that's for sure. Along the coast, with that brisk wind, it will feel quite fresh, but inland temperatures easily getting up into the low to mid-20s. Very nice too, and it stays fine and dry through this evening and overnight, cooling down nicely, so not too steamy tonight. In fact, in some rural spots, we'll get as low as, 10 or 11 degrees. So a fresh start to another pleasant day tomorrow. Again, some fair weather cloud, but bags of sunshine, especially down towards the south coast, I fancy. Similar sorts of temperatures, so along the coast 20, 21 degrees, inland 24, possibly 25. But as we've said at the start, it is set to turn very hot indeed through Sunday and especially Monday into the low 30s. Thankfully for many, it won't last. By the middle of the week, we're kind of back down to normal.
What a strange summer we're having, aren't we, John?
Up and down, yeah.
Thank you very much. Well, that's it from me and the lunchtime team. Back now to Lewis with the rest of the news. Bye-bye.